Continuing our exploration of health span, healthy aging, today I would like to address something called deregulated nutrient sensing. This is a very interesting and complex dance between aging and deregulated nutrient sensing. Let me explain how it works. So, our bodies rely on the intricate cellular pathways to sense the availability of nutrients and adjust metabolism accordingly. The nutrient sensing is very crucial for maintaining healthy cell function and preventing the damaging effects of over or under nutrition. However, with age and various lifestyle factors, what happens is that these pathways can become deregulated, contributing to the aging process. So let me give you a breakdown of this. Nutrient sensing pathways involve key players like insulin, something called GF1 signaling, mTOR, sirtuins, and AMPK. These are names for signal molecules. And when there is aging or stress or other lifestyle factors, then the pathways get deregulated. And so there is what is called increased cellular stress. This can cause damage to DNA, to proteins, and other cellular components. There's also something called decreased cellular repair mechanisms. The ability to repair damage becomes less efficient. And there's altered cell growth and differentiation, which can lead to uncontrolled cell division and dysfunction. Can we slow it down? Yes. The most interesting thing is calorie restriction. Reducing calorie intake while maintaining adequate nutrition has been shown to extend lifespan in many organisms. And this is due to the prevention of the deregulated nutrient sensing. Intermittent fasting, which is a favorite practice of mine, at least once or twice a week, or three times a week, or sometimes the entire week. And this involves usually alternating periods of eating and fasting, which may mimic some of the benefits of caloric restriction. So intermittent fasting means eating whatever you eat, moderately, of course, but within an 8-hour period. And then, of course, focusing on nutrient quality, consuming a diet rich in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and lean protein may support optimal nutrient sensing. Once again, lifestyle factors are the most important. Quality sleep, exercise, stress management. I always mention number one, stress management, number two, meditation, number three, movement, both aerobic but mind-body coordination and exercise. Number four, emotions. And number five, diet. So simple. We can extend that, of course, to many other things, including biological rhythms. And my most favorite is, of course, looking at the body, not as a physical entity, even though we're talking about all these nutrient interventions, but as I always maintain, even food is modified consciousness. So when we practice all these and maintain optimal biological rhythms, we can slow down and prevent for a while deregulated nutrient sensing.